Hello, everyone, and thank you once again for joining me, Jan Harp, and my wonderful husband, Mr. Chris.
Hello, everybody. How you doing? And we are back.
Elections.
Elections.
So we were discussing the fact that information is not disseminated the way that it used to be.
That's what I'm saying. What's happening now is a complete and utter
catastrophe. Mockery of our democracy.
A complete mock, like you said, of democracy. It's because people views on certain things of other people that they would think that's all right.
Sadly.
Because it's going to benefit them. Uh-huh. But when it don't benefit them and it changes, then they have a problem. So what I'm saying about people, it's not a problem until it start affecting you. So now you can sit there all day long. Everybody here can sit there and talk about democracy and everything else. Now, if it's not affecting you or your liberties or whatever else at that moment, but how do you feel when it start affecting you? How do you feel when it's not your team that's doing it or it switched it up?
We started these back in April. We talked a little bit about that, about how, you know, when it was over in China, it was okay.
Yes.
You know? Oh, they have to walk around with masks. They need to walk around with those masks, you know? And as long as it's in someone else's backyard, then it's completely okay. You know, they need to do what they need to do. But then as soon as it's in your yard, then it's like, no, you're infringing upon my civil liberties. You're infringing upon my rights. And it's like, you know, I get it. I understand you want to have something to stand for. You want to have something to, you know, rally behind. But we
That's
are now in the millions. We're, you
when
know,
it comes
millions.
To- Safety
infected, and
yes,
the key thing is those who have recovered, many of them now have illnesses that keep them from functioning at the same level they were able to function before all of this happened, before everything, you know, came to light. They had one assumption about the way that this COVID-19 operated in people's bodies, and now as they're learning more and they're understanding more, things are coming to the surface about what it does to kids. This whole new category that happens to them. I mean, I don't want to leave my house. I don't understand what would make anyone want to leave their house if they don't have to. If it's not a client-related issue, I'm in my house. My kid is in the house. I don't know why anyone wants to go out the house. You have to grab hold to information. You have to look outside of your own borders, and you have to understand, okay, if this information was valid for there, their numbers are in the hundreds of thousands, then hey, that information may be valid for us and it will keep us from getting into the millions like we are right now.
Exactly.
It'll keep more people from dying. It'll keep kids from being sick. You know, I mean, there was just one place. Oh, I'm so bad with the names, but where was it? Of places.
We can't steal you.
But just recently, one of the countries that had...
Oh, a country?
Yes, yeah. It's a country. We was it New that. Zealand?
New Zealand.
They had like a spike of like 100 cases and they shut everything back down. They was like, no. Same thing in Trinidad. They're shutting back down
for 108 days of no
cases.
No cases, no spreading, no nothing. In 108 days. And then they spiked up. Something happened or what? I don't know. They opened back up and something happened. But they isolated where they thought it was and everything else. And they came to like not even 100. I think it was like 91 or 92 cases, and got them people isolated and everything else. And they shut everything down just from them 90 something people. They shut everything down again.
As they should.
Again, just shut everything down.
As they should.
Which was awesome. We're in election time. This is America, and everybody seemed to think that, you know, oh, this is the land of the promised land. It ain't never been the promised land for black people.
I can't.
Never been us ever. No, just to throw that in there, my wife like to be good, we strong, or whatever else, but it's never been the promised land for us, ever.
No, it's not that. It's not that.
And it's a beautiful thing.
This brings me into something weird. I guess it's a little controversial, but we have to look once again outside of our own borders, and we have to look to see how is it that other people do things. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the day, Chinese people, they have it down. I salute you. People who are part of the Arab community, they get it. Once again, I salute
Africa
you.
Did so well.
You know, people get it.
So Africa did very well, and they did very well.
Africa did very well, and I understand.
Yeah, on the poor scale and everything else.
Here, even here, like when you look here, these are other racial groups, is that they get it when it comes to solidarity. And unfortunately, you know, it may be very controversial to say it, but us African Americans, we don't get it when it comes to solidarity. We will stop doing business with each other before we even start doing business with each other. You could do whatever you want to, but you know, I'm telling the truth. We have this basis that limits so much of our progress. We have a basis when it comes to therapy. You know, that's like a taboo. We have an issue when it comes to certain types of communication. Oh, that makes your men look weak. I mean, it's just like all these things, like, oh, in order for a woman to be strong, she can't, you know, show any sadness. She can't show any weakness. And it's just like we have all these things, and they're like norms within our cultures. Like, it's just across all of our little racial cultural groups, where even if they come from outside of the country and they end up in the black community, like, you know, they're, because their skin is darker and they end up in the black community, it's almost like they adopt it onto themselves too, where it's like, oh, you know, this is what we can accomplish. This is how people see us. And then we put ourselves in these boxes, and then we have the nerve after isolating ourselves from everything else because of fear of rejection or fear of failure or whatever it is, then we have the nerve to then isolate each other from each other. I'm not dealing with her because she looked at me the wrong way. Maybe she was having a bad day. But even with holistic coaching, if someone's in my same market, once you're set up, I'm willing to refer to you and help promote you all day. Now, helping you set up, I'll have to point you in a different direction, because it doesn't make sense for me to use all of my marketing, you know, tactics that I've come up with to help you set up an industry that's exactly mirrors to mine. That doesn't make sense.
But once you get in there and you got one.
So, you know, and I know about
referral
you.
Referral service and things definitely. Like that. We definitely do that part. So.
And it's just, you know, it's crazy. I mean, it's so many different ways that we can be cohesive, and we can come up with just, you know, a platform that has absolutely nothing to do with outside input. You know, we don't need the government to make a mandate that says that, you know, we support each other. That should be something that we're able to come up with internally. The same way Asians are able to come up with it internally. Arabs are able to come up with it internally.
Exactly.
And it's Caucasians are able to come up with it internally.
We had that issue, and that's the issue we need. If we're going to do it and make it, we have to get rid of it. I've always been good with people, everything else. And the main thing is not the fact of a certain people they want to work with because you this or you that. It's just they work with their people because that's what they do. They don't care about the deal or you got a better deal because you here. Or no, they just deal with their people. And then when we get on that same page, we good.
I don't get mad.
We are good.
I don't get mad at people because
no, I'll never get mad at any of that.
To their people.
To their people. Exactly.
It really only boils down to the issue here in the U.S. You know, the black-white issue. As soon as we say to ourselves that there's no more black-white issue, then there's no more black-white issue. The government can't mandate for there not to be a black-white issue. So, I mean, you have people who have a mind state that says, I'm not doing certain things. And you can't get mad at them as long as they're saying that from over there and they're not infringing upon your personal space over here. And mm-hmm. no one is infringing upon our personal space over here for us not to have a belief system and make it into a moral value within our community that says, no, if there's a business down the block that's a black business, then you patronize it. If it's a business that's a black business, work with them slide and scale if you know that they can't afford it. Like, key thing. So we already understand there's certain things that are influenced by bias within our society. It just is. And if you are a person, you know, who is a Caucasian in our society, and you say, oh, I don't see color, and, you know, blah, 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 you know, that's beautiful, and I'm happy for your heart in that. But at the end of the day, the system sees color. And when we go for a loan, there's some bias in that. So what angers me sometimes in my heart is that a lot of us will not give credence to black businesses because they don't have all of the aesthetics that make it pop for us to say that that's a legitimate business. They are a legitimate business. If they have their EIN number and they have, you know, their state registration, and they have, you know, whether they're federal 501c3 or whatever it is that they need it in order for them to be set up as a legal business, then that's a business. And you need to congratulate them, even if their tables and chairs don't match each other.
On that, sweetie, is that what a lot of black people have an issue with, and I think it's so ridiculous, is talking about the pricing of stuff or any of that. Now, oh, somebody's selling some food here, mm-hmm. and it's 50 cent, might be 50 cent more because they rent higher on the building, which most black people ain't thinking about that. Mm-hmm. But once you're renting a building, or you don't own the building, or whatever else, and your rent is higher than whoever else to pay, and cause your hot dog is 50 cent more, and could taste way better mm-hmm. than the franchise or whatever hot dog down the street. And some, oh, I can get it over here for 50. You know, it's ridiculous.
All right, well, that's two-sided. That's two-sided now.
No, because a lot of people go on the money issue and everything else.
No, but it's okay if it's only 50 cents more. But is it the customer's fault if you go and you open up the shop that causes you to have overhead, that causes me to have to now pay something maybe $4 or $5 or maybe even $10 overpriced compared to what's in the community?
See, but that's our community and our social thing of ownership that mm-hmm. we had to get into to have those prices mm-hmm. and compete with those prices. Now, once we own our own commercial property, as long as you're supporting your own economic system, because everybody have their own economic system except us.
And that's what I'm in agreement with that. What I said was
mm-hmm. the pricing, or we having that and having our own commercial buildings, we can rent to each other or whatever else. It might bring the price down, and we can have these competitive prices for everybody.
No, that's going to be different because you have to have baby steps, because no, everybody cannot afford. Listen, there's been numerous places that have priced me out their doors, and I wanted to support them as black businesses, but they just too expensive for me. Some stuff I can't afford. And if I can't afford
but let me
no matter
tell
how
you
much
something.
I want to do
because
it,
which, I'm proud of those people. If any black business can get in there and get in their lane mm-hmm. and get into this a position to where they can get money from tourism mm-hmm. all day long. I don't have to go there. I want you to get your money, and I love it when you get the tourism money, and you can charge the more expensive prices and have people. I love you for it. I still love you.
Yes.
I love you for it, and I'm proud of you. I just can't be your customer because I can't afford to be there, but I love how you did that and how you got in that position. Yes. Just don't forget about the people, which I know no one does anyway. All the ones I've known that came in that position, they never did. They never forgot about it.
So. We have to take some responsibility is what I'm saying. You know, yes. What we're both saying, you know, we yes. can look at it from two different perspectives, but at the end of the day, we're saying is that there is enough freedom in society. There's enough leeway. There's enough technology. There's enough access at this point where even if there's nothing else we can do, we can at the very least validate each other, right? You know the struggle it takes for someone to open up their doors as a minority business. Validate that person, regardless to where you feel they are in their decor, in their aesthetics. And then number two, support that. You know what I mean? In whatever way you can. If you can't patronize them, the least you could do is share it on Facebook. You know what I mean? There's all different ways to support. That's why I'm always saying find your lane. At the end of the day, most importantly, most importantly, is like I always say, research. You know, you have to do your due diligence and say, okay, you know, is this storefront going to create so much overhead that my product is going to, you know, price out my target market? Because if your target market is, you know, the tourism industry or people who, you know, have high incomes, okay, great, awesome. But you got to go with where they are. You can't be where I am when I'm looking for my $10 discount. Other cultures support each other, but at the same point in time, please, after we have decided to support, you know, just try not to price us out the market, because sometimes y'all do. I've put on the platforms different questions about
sweatsuits and go Yeezys, baby.
I give up.
You good.
I've been putting some different political posts online. So I personally try to stay neutral. Of course, I have my side, but I try to stay neutral. And then you really can't go by me. When I took my MBA classes, my professor used to tell me all the time that she said, I'm the kind of consumer that, you know, people who come up with marketing plans, they are intrigued by me because you never know which way I'm going to go. Today, I may love, you know, Victoria's
Secret. I married her, and I don't know no date which way we going. I can, what? None.
In other words, I have no brand loyalty.
So she right about that one.
I can't. You open up a $7 store, I'm coming to your $7 store, and I'm leaving my $10 store. It's just, I have no brand loyalties. But, and that translates over into politics. I have no brand loyalty. It's just... So when I'm saying I'm in the middle, I mean I'm in the middle. Like, elections, right?
We can elections. Do it too.
Elections.
Right? Oh, we're going to elections.
Giving away your vote. So this is what I've been. Okay, so like I said, I'm truly neutral. I'm in the middle, right? So at the end of the day, what I've come to
believe.
How
do you get to the middle?
I can't. Just know. When I'm online and I'm posting and I'm asking you, convince me. I'm one of them people who you need to really run your spiel past.
I know you're in the middle, but I'm asking you.
You can convince me. You convince somebody else. And that means that you got it down pat. You're able to have a broad view and be able to explain it and express it to someone in a way that makes them listen versus being offended. You can't convince someone of anything if they're offended. But if I'm listening to you, then we can reason with each other.
You're getting much better at that.
Me?
Yeah, you're real good at that. You're getting better. She wasn't good at it, but she's getting better.
Okay, so online we've been talking about, you know, these different political views and so on and so forth. And one of the things where I differ from most people is my understanding of what it means to give your vote away. So...
Sure, market the channel how we used to with YouTube, but we can't.